Okay, so I think we should get straight into this week's curriculum, and then we can talk about some catch up later. I mean, we covered like with going through exercise. I think we got a refresher on functions and on loops and on if statements. So then maybe we can do some exercise. Then we can see what's missing. But I think what we should do now is talk about some of the new stuff we're going to learn about. So a lot of you have already become familiar with objects. So in JavaScript, we say there's like this saying that everything is an object, because in JavaScript, almost everything is an object. And the things that are not objects is very subtle, so you can just think about everything as objects. And what objects can do is that you can give things, it's kind of like almost like an array or like a set of variables that you can put together, and then you can give them names. So I mean, we already kind of saw it. I think we should... Oh, you need paper? So if we continue, we could extend the student manager program that we had been developing so far. So, for example, we can make, we have an array of students, and instead of just having the names of the students in here, now I'm just gonna add a couple of people that I can remember the names of. So instead of so this is kind of like what we've been doing so far, in that we had an array of student names that were in a class, and we had the function to add more students to the class to check that we didn't add the same student twice. But for example, what if we wanted to add also the age of the student? So I don't know, how old are you? 32.
32? Yeah.
Okay. How old are you, Zoe?
Write yourself first. 28. No! 28.
28? I thought he said 38. Okay, so we can of course do this, and then we just know that the first element in the student ages matches up with the first element in the student names, and we can of course extend this, and we can have all these different data, put them in arrays. But right now it's kind of, it would be nicer if we could put the things together in the same, co-locate them next to each other. So what we can do is that we can make use objects instead. And the way you define an object is that you use the curly braces, the tuborgklammer in Danish that we talked about.
What is it?
Tubor?
It looks like
tubos. Okay, let's go. Take it away. I love this one. Curly braces. It's because okay, that's not very good pictures here. I'm just gonna find. So tubal, the beer, and it's because the top of the hat here kind of looks like a curly brace. Yeah. Can you see how you have the round part and then you have the tip and then you have the round part back again? So programmers call them tuborgklammer. Okay. Anyway, we already know these. One thing that's kind of starting to show now is that when people were inventing programming languages, they quickly ran out of symbols. So sometimes now we start to get what's called ambiguity, in the sense that now the same symbols are used for very different things all over the place. So for example, the curly braces, which we also use to define a block with a for loop or is or if statement or with a function, they also mean create a new object. But what we can do here is then we can put kind of these things in there that are almost like variables, but they're called properties. You probably heard me say the word a couple of times that we access a property. So we can, for example, put name in here. And then we can put one called age. Then let's do the next ones. Oh yeah. And okay, so let's just run this code. Okay, so maybe let's take one at a time. So this was our student names array. Sorry. Moving all over the place. This was our student ages array, and then we have the students array. See, it kind of looks the same. But the nice thing now is that now we can, for example, say, okay, I want to take the first student for what, and I want to say, okay, what is the name? So I dot into it. And this, we've already seen it with, you know, when we did the math exercises with math.random and math.reduce. We've also seen it with arrays. You can dot onto an array, you can dot onto a string. If we run this code, then we can see we get out the name of student zero. So this way we can put all these different properties on there. For example, if we look at another one, now I'm just imagining, but for example, math would look like, you know, we have the random on there. That would be something, I don't know what it is. Let's just put it like this. And we would have the round and so on. So math is also just an object. Let's take a student again. I should put some comments in here. So all of this, I'm gonna commit all this to GitHub, so you can find it later. Okay. Let's go back to the student. I just want to put some more comments. Let's actually do a little bit more general person, and we're just gonna put me in there. So my name, I'm gonna put my age again, and then we could also do something different. So we could say, for example, role, and I'm a teacher. And we can add all the properties in here we want, and they can be all different things. We could also say, you know, we could have classes in here, so we could say something like JavaScript 1 and JavaScript 2. If we later in our program want to add some new things to an object, we can also do that, and it's almost like doing variables. So we can say person, and then we can say last name. So if we first run this, you can see it comes out with the data we put in there. Then we run this, And you can see suddenly there's a new property in there called last name. So you can use this to like build up objects that have different data in there, and you can put whatever data you want. You can of course also nest it, so you can have objects of objects. So what's an object we could put in here?
Hobbies.
Yeah. What do we want to do?
Favorites. Second favorites.
Yeah.
Sports.
Yes. Favorite team.
What?
Favorite team.
Yeah. Let's do it. Okay. Computers. Sports. I don't know. Running. Running to class. Yeah. Okay. I've been humiliated enough. Let's go on to the next thing. So of course you can put whatever thing you want in here. We can also remove things again. So say for example that we added the last name, but we didn't, for example, we were trying to not infringe on people's privacy, so we want to get rid of the last name again, then we can write this special keyword in front called delete. So if we look at the person now, well, okay, I need to run this again to get the hobbies in there. And then run this to get the last name. Okay, so you can see this is what the object looks like now. We have the things we defined up here, and then we have the last name we added up here. And then if we run this piece of code, then the last name is gone again. Now that we had one more thing we need to cover is we have the person, and we want to get the hobbies. Of course, that gives us back an object. If we want to get anything inside the object, it's kind of the same principle that we've learned so many times with substitution, that you can then do the same thing again. So we can say, okay, we want to dot into the favorites, and then we get computers out. So you can see now, and you'll see there's a lot in code, you can get these long chains where people dot 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 into things. I think we also saw it when we were talking about dot replace, where so first we could replace one string, and then we could dot again, replace another string, and dot again. You know, where we did like this. And the idea here was that you could first do this in your head, and then you could replace the result, and then you could do the rest in your head. So if we try to do this, you can see now the result of this would be high world, and then if we run high world with the last one, then we get high verden. So kind of, you know, the same substitution principles, and the first we can run, you know, this piece of code, and then we get out the object with the favorites and the sport in there, and then we couldn't in principle replace that in there. We could do like this if we wanted to, just for sake of illustration. Then you could also see it like this, and then we do this. So let's say, so these two lines are kind of the same. Of course, then if anyone were to update the favorites or the hobbies somewhere, then this object is not the same, of course, but you know, for the sake of argument, this is also something you could do. I think the last thing we need to cover here with just the basics of objects is
you have a question.
Yeah.
The object property is,
yeah.
Isn't it fixed?
No, we can change it.
We can change it?
Yes. So we could for example, when is my, you know, dot age, and you can do all the things you normally do. You can say plus plus, for example, to increase the age, or you can say age is equal to a new number, or you can update anything inside the object. For example, you could also say, okay, we could make a function. We could make a function to say we graduated a class. Now, some things we want to do here is that we want to say, student we call it classes, right? Yeah. We could say, okay, you cannot graduate the same class twice. This is kind of like the add student to class method we had before. And we can say, okay, so if we run this, what are we gonna call this? It's because class is one of those words that are reserved in JavaScript. You cannot call something class. So we have to say class name. Okay. Then we can look at the person now. Now it's JavaScript 1 and JavaScript 2. And then we can say, okay, the person graduated HTML. Do this. Console log the person. And now you can see HTML is put in there.
Yeah.
This is often when you're writing JavaScript, a lot of the time it's about making these kind of functions. You know, function that takes in an object and does something with the object, and then use the object to contain your data and move it around in your when you have very large programs. We can try this one also. Say, run the same thing again. And then of course we get the error.
Questions so far? In the object you have mentioned the name, age and everything. So when I assign or maybe when I add any object, I have to give all the properties like name, age, hobbies, everything, or maybe I can I can give two, only two.
Yeah.
Is it possible?
Yes. Yeah. So you can up here we made them all the same, but you can do whatever you want in here. So we can, for example, say or like
No. Suppose in a object there is only name and age and role.
Yeah.
I want to create one only with name and age, not the role.
Yeah.
So.
So yes, so you can of course say this.
Every time when we're adding a new person, we have to declare it in new variable?
Yes.
Can we put it, or if we put it, then we have to put it inside the array, yeah?
We can also put it inside array, so we could, for example, make a, now this is getting very long, but we can use the students variable from up the top, and we can make a function that says add student. And we could say, student here. And then what we want to do in the end is that we want to say students and then we can do all the checks in here, for example. Well, now it's a very simple function, so let's just keep this one first, and we can just have one where we say name is for him, right?
Yeah.
So we can do it like this, for example. Just to remember, we had a variable all here up in the beginning, said students.
Yeah.
Or like, that was an array. And we can run this, and now you can see, okay, now we have different kinds of objects in there. But I think what you're asking is that you know a language where you have to make a class and you have to make a constructor and that kind of stuff. Is that what you're asking? In JavaScript, there's no rules about this. This object is just a very generic way to contain data. So you can put anything you want in there. It doesn't have to look the same or be homogeneous or anything. You can just do whatever you want. So normally that's why normally you have maybe these kind of, you know, utility functions that helps you make sure the data is the same format. So sometimes you'll say, for example, student dot name is not equal to null, for example. Oh well, we want to say if it is something like this. So now we can only add a student if they have a name and they have an age. And of course we can go even more crazy and we can say, okay, and you know, student name is a string. And we can also say, and you know, student name dot length has to be, you know, you cannot have a name that's one letter, and you can go crazy like that to make sure that all the data looks the same. The last thing I think we need to cover, and this is maybe going to be a little bit confusing.
An object can be an array or a normal object.
So that's one of the tricky things in JavaScript, and I think you're going to be confused now. So far we've seen we can do a person.name, but we can also do person.name like this. So if we do this, that's Emil. Do this, also Emil. We can also say, again, using that substitution principle where we say, okay, prop is equal to this name thing, then we substitute name in there, and then we get it. And you might be thinking, is this, you know, we can also, of course, just gonna use a new name now. We can do this. And now the name is Maria. And another thing we can do that's even more maybe confusing is that we can say this. And now person all of a sudden has a property called zero. That's called hello world. And you know, when you look at this, you might think, is that an array? But it's not an array, it's an object. Yeah, so, but in reality, what people do is that they don't do this. Sometimes you do this one up here because you want to be dynamic at what property are we getting. For example, you might have, you might sometimes see a function called, this is a very common function. That people do, and they say, okay, so since in JavaScript you cannot make sure that objects always have the same properties, sometimes you have this function, you say, okay, I want to take the person and I want to get that job, and if they don't have a job set there, you want to get back something like unknown. So if we run this code, again, I did something I'm not supposed to. Like this, and then, of course, on person, we don't have a property here called job. So when we run this, we get back unknown. But if we instead set something like age, then we get 25. So it's kind of a way to say, I want to get, you know, I want to check out what is this property. And if I don't have a default, if I don't have a value, then I'm going to get back some default value. So you can see that's where you use something like this dynamic way of saying, okay, I want to get out this specific one.
Does that answer your question?
Or is it just more confusing?
can you elaborate your question?
Yeah, actually, my question was at the start when you started with declaring the property for the object.
Yeah.
At the very first time. So
up here?
Yeah. You just put the square brackets and inside that you have declared with the property.
Yeah.
My question is that, like, it looks like you are declaring an array of elements.
Yes.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
My question is that always we declare the object like this, or we can just remove the square brackets from the start.
Then it won't be an array. Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
Yeah, but it can be an object.
No.
Yeah.
Yeah, but
no.
Ah, no. So you cannot do this if that's what you mean.
No.
Because
in an
object, you always need to have a key. That's what you call this thing, a key, and a value.
But down there, variable person. Can you see you use the curly brackets and the name and.
Yeah.
Yes, exactly. That's because I was just making the object itself.
That's what I was asking.
Okay, so I could also have done this.
Yeah.
So is this an array?
This is an array.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Array of objects.
Array of objects.
See, you could also have done this where I mix it up. So I put it first, the object into a variable, and then I put the variable into the array, or something like that. So you can mix and match all of these things. The very last thing we need to cover with objects for now, and then we should start doing, well, it's actually already lunch. Yeah. The last thing we need to cover with objects, we've seen how you can add new properties. You can just kind of like when you define variables, of course, you cannot put var in front of this because that doesn't make sense in JavaScript. Because you're not making a variable, you're putting a new property onto an object. And the same goes, where did we have it? This one up here. You cannot say var in front of that because it doesn't make sense in JavaScript. So we're not exactly making variables, we're making properties. Last fun thing is that we can also carry around, we can also put functions in there. So we kind of skipped up on the on this math thing up here, but what the math object looks like inside JavaScript is that it has functions on here. Now, I don't know how to write this, so we're just gonna make a function that always returns 42. And then this one here was rounding off a number. So if, see, how do we do this?
Or you can just add a function into the person that calculates, I don't know, how many classes he's teaching.
But does it get, I have a question about context then. I don't know if it gets the right context. Let's see if this works. Yeah, exactly. So how do you?
You just use a con.
But then how do we get the right person?
Then you need to use this.
Yeah, so that's a problem. So skip that one. Okay. But I mean, at least we've seen how you can pass these objects around, and you can access the properties in a number of different ways. The delete keyword you can always put in front here, like this. It's not very common to delete things from objects. Normally you just add new things all the time, and then once in a while you need this delete keyword. But it's, I think, at least for me, it's pretty rare.
Which means don't abuse it.
Yeah.
So if you add something that you wouldn't like to use, or you're not using later, you can just let it be there.
Well, you could, yeah, and potentially you could. Then the question is, once you add these things in there, if another programmer comes and sees that these properties, then you know. And normally, if, for example, if I was using it inside a function or something, then normally I make a little variable to. I don't put things on the object, I make it a little variable, and then at the end, maybe I put something on the object. I think is that good for now?
Yeah, good for now.
Okay.
Do you guys understand? Or do you guys not understand?
Okay. We'll test it in a moment when you get exercise, but now we have 20 minutes for lunch, and I already used 6 minutes, so 26. We have to be back here because now we're starting to get a pretty tight schedule.
So what time do we come back?
26.
26.
26 past 2.
2:26. Okay.
How many? 20 minutes. Yeah, 20 minutes.